Hey guys, Kevin here. Today I'd like to show you how to make a one pan maple salmon dinner. It's a great meal for a chilly autumn or winter evening. And the best part, the whole dinner, which includes Brussels sprouts and butternut squash, cooks on a single sheet pan in just 35 minutes. For easy cleanup, I always line the sheet pan with aluminum foil. Anyway, to get started, preheat your oven to 425 degrees Fahrenheit. So I bought this butternut squash already peeled and chopped at my local supermarket. What a time saver. It's about a pound, actually just slightly less than a pound. And we're going to pour this onto the baking sheet. I may not use all of it. And then give it a drizzle of olive oil. The olive oil is going to help the squash to caramelize in the oven. Then give it a sprinkling of salt. I'm using kosher salt here. And some grinds of black pepper. Then give it a toss with your hands, just to make sure all of the cubes are coated with the oil and the seasonings. Then prepare the Brussels sprouts. I always shave off this little discolored portion from where the sprout was attached to the plant's stem, and then cut each sprout lengthwise in half. And if your sprouts are really large, and some of mine are, go ahead and cut each half in half to make quarters. Then add the Brussels sprouts to the baking sheet. Give them too a drizzle of olive oil. And a generous sprinkling of salt. And freshly ground black pepper, and toss with your hands. And then put the veggies in the oven and let them cook for exactly 25 minutes. Let's see, timer 2-5. While the veggies are cooking, make a simple maple marinade. The maple marinade is simple indeed. What we need is about 2 tablespoons of Dijon mustard. And we're putting this in a smallish bowl. Here's the mustard. And then we're going to add, a pinch of kosher salt, some grinds of black pepper, and 2 tablespoons of pure maple syrup. My syrup is in a jar because it came as a gift from my piano tuner. He tapped his sugar sap maple trees late last winter, and boy, was I happy to receive a pint of the syrup as a gift. In the comments section below, let me know if you've ever tapped your own maple trees. Sounds like a fun project. Actually, it sounds like a lot of work. Okay, then we need some salmon fillets. And since it's just 2 for dinner tonight, I have 2 6-ounce center cut salmon fillets, skin removed. Although you could certainly do two, three, or even four salmon fillets for your own sheet pan dinner. And what we're going to do is, well, we could put this in the bowl, but since my salmon is already in this little package, I'm just going to pour the marinade on top. I'll kind of rub it over the fillets, lift the fillets so that the marinade goes underneath. And then we're going to, after I wash my hands, I'm going to put this in the refrigerator. And here are the veggies. As you can see, the Brussels sprouts have started to caramelize nicely, and the butternut squash has turned a darker shade of gold, which is just what we want. I'm going to give the sprouts a little toss. Ditto for the squash. And as you can see, I kept the squash and the Brussels sprouts on separate sides of the pan for no good reason other than I want to have room for my salmon fillets. And here they are. They've been marinating in the refrigerator while the veggies cooked. On they go. And again, these are 6-ounce salmon fillets, skin off, center cut. This goes into the oven for exactly 10 minutes. This next step is entirely up to you. To make a garnish for the salmon, grab 3 sage leaves. These came from my garden. And we're going to cut these into a chiffonade. So stack the leaves and then roll them lengthwise as if you were rolling a cigar. You know how to roll a cigar. And then cut crosswise like this into thin strips. And there we have it, a chiffonade of sage. Okay, here's our finished sheet pan dinner. And let me tell you, it smells terrific. So the only thing we have to do is garnish the naked looking salmon fillets with the smoky fresh sage. And here we are, all plated up and ready for a taste test. Well, I've already tasted a Brussels sprout and a piece of the butternut squash, and I can tell you that both of them are sweetly caramelized. Just amazing. Now, a little piece of the salmon. Oh, you guys, the salmon is creamy because it's not overcooked, and the combination of Dijon mustard and maple syrup is an absolute match made in heaven. I just love the sweetness and the savoriness of it. Okay, I'm going to go into the dining room to finish this meal, but let me just say that who needs the fast food drive-through when this maple salmon sheet pan dinner is not only easy to make, but it cooks really quickly. Again, just 35 minutes total. I hope you'll give this dish a try someday. I also hope you'll post a comment below. And if you have any recipes you'd like me to try, by all means, shout them out. I'll see you next time with another delicious recipe. Bye for now.